Welcome to Utah State University's Equine Science and Management Program in the College of Agriculture and Applied Sciences. This series of videos outlines equine safety and handling for the Animal, Dairy, and Veterinary Sciences Department.
Listen closely to the information in the videos. Your safety, as well as those around you, depends on proper horse handling techniques and understanding equine behavior. We are excited to work together and help build your equine knowledge.
Herd behavior. Horses are prey animals. They rely on the flight versus fight or agonistic behavior. Horses are also gregarious, meaning they tend to associate with others of one's kind. Gregarious originates from the Latin word grex, meaning herd. Being prey animals, they establish a herd that allows for them to feel safe and less vulnerable to predators. In the wild, obedience to leadership means survival. To obtain order and leadership, dominant behavior must be displayed to establish hierarchy within a herd. Continual threats of aggression are necessary to maintain hierarchy. Agonistic. Agonistic includes fighting, flight, and other reactions associated with conflict. The horse is programmed to continually display agonistic behavior daily in all levels of interaction, including the interactions displayed with humans. So where do you stand in the pecking order? Reactive is a classification of activities used by an animal to keep itself in harmony with its environment and adjust to sudden, potentially harmful situations. Here are some forms of reactive behavior. Simple reflex is when a horse will withdraw a limb in response to local pain. A horse communicates through body language, which can be seen when they maintain visual contact and exchange signals. Ingestive behavior includes eating, drinking, food preferences, daily patterns of feeding, the mechanics of obtaining food, and chewing food. The horse is a grazing animal designed to eat constantly. They will graze for 12 to 16 hours a day. Eliminative refers to urination and defecation. A horse urinates every 4 to 6 hours and can defecate every 2 to 3 hours. This can vary depending on the stimulus given by the environment. Sexual behavior involves courtship, mating, and maternal behavior. Stallions become more aggressive, vocal, and display the flamen reaction. Flamen response is the term used to describe the behavior in which a horse extends its neck, raises its head, and inhales as it rolls its upper lip back, displaying its front teeth. Horses display the flamen response to facilitate transfer of inhaled scent molecules, otherwise known as pheromones, into the nasal organ. Mares show signs of heat such as frequent urination and winking. Winking is when a mare will open and close the lower part of her vulva. Epimeletic characterizes the behavior of mutual grooming, caregiving, and care-seeking. Examples of epimeletic activities are standing nose to tail to swat flies, nibbling, and licking. Mimicry, or allelomimetic, are when horses copy behavior of other horses. This is closely related to gregarious behavior. Sleep and rest allow horses to restore physiological status and make metabolic recoveries in a short time. The course of a 24-hour day consists of 19 hours of being alert, 2 hours in a drowsy state. They achieve a total of 3 hours a day of REM, brain and body sleep, which can only occur when the horse is laying down. A stay apparatus allows horses to lock their legs and relax muscles without falling over. Body language. Here are some key factors to understanding body language on a horse. If the ears are forward, the horse is alert or paying attention. Relaxed ears mean the horse is in a resting state. When the ears are pinned back, the horse is uncomfortable, typically irritated or upset. If the eyes are relaxed, the horse is calm. When the horse is wide-eyed, they are alarmed. If the nose is relaxed, the horse is calm. A dilated nose means they are alert or aware. When the nose is wrinkled, the horse is annoyed. If the mouth is loose-lipped, the horse is relaxed. If he is licking his lips, he is thinking and passive. If the teeth are bared, the horse is aggressive. When the horse's tail is relaxed, so are they. Tightly clamped tails mean they are uncomfortable. If the tail is arched or flagged, they are excited and happy or scared and nervous. When the horse is standing with one leg cocked, the horse is in a resting, calm state. The difference between a headset that is high versus low is the state of their alertness. High is very alert and low is relaxed. Body language is the key to understanding how to interact with the horse in its current state or mood. Let's examine human equine mimicry. The key to establishing dominance is being able to move the horse around. To establish dominance, a horse uses his body. Examples would be biting, kicking, and striking. Once dominance has been established, the more aggressive actions lessen, and the dominant horse then uses his body language to push others around. This includes pinning ears, slight head swing, and movement towards another horse. You can take most of the same principles from herd behavior and apply them to human interactions with horses. Using body language can help you establish dominance, understand reactions and behaviors, and help with the safety of both you and the animal. The key to establish dominance is being able to move the horse around.